Hello friends, what's up? Welcome to my channel Keratoconus Hub TV. Today I will tell you very important things that every keratoconus patient should know about corneal collagen cross-linking. It is also known as cross-linking CXL or C3R. This video will help you in understanding why the vision worsens when someone suffers from keratoconus. So let's understand how the keratoconus is robbing your eyesight. Our cornea has tiny fibers of protein called as corneal collagen. These are the structural components of the cornea. The main function of corneal collagen is to keep the structure of cornea intact by acting as a framework. But when someone suffers from keratoconus, the cornea becomes thin and starts to bulge outward into conical shape. Although there are many causes of keratoconus, but a major culprit is free radicals damage. The free radicals are harmful byproducts that are produced in the metabolism process. These free radicals are produced by our body tissues. In the same way, these harmful free radicals are also generated by the corneal tissues. We can consider the collagen as a framework of steel beams. If some heavy enough objects are bombarded over the steel frame, it will bend. Exactly analogous phenomena happens in the case of keratoconus. Here the free radicals get bombarded over the corneal structure to make it weaker continuously. If the cornea is healthy, it can easily defend itself from such harmful free radicals. But the cornea of a keratoconic eye has a weak self-defense system to fight with these free radicals. This weakening is caused by the lack of antioxidants, as the antioxidants have the power to trap the harmful free radicals. So, if not treated on time, these free radicals may continue to damage the corneal collagen and thus worsening the vision. So the first thing is to stop the progression. A very popular technique used to stop the progression of keratoconus is the corneal collagen cross-linking. It is also named as cross-linking, CXL, C3R, CCL, and KXL. The cross-linking technique has the potential to slow down or to stop the progression of keratoconus. In very few cases, it has also resulted in improved vision to some extent. The reason behind this little improvement in the vision is flattening of the cornea due to CXL. This flattening reduces the corneal cone and hence somewhat improved eyesight. For more help about keratoconus, you are welcome on my blog www.keratoconushub.com. I will keep on adding more videos regularly to keep you updated with new advancements in keratoconus. To get the notifications of my new videos, don't forget to subscribe my channel, Keratoconus Hub TV. Thank you for watching. Have a nice day.